Hey y'all, hey, welcome back to the Gangster Chef's Kitchen, where I teach you how to fall in love with yourself in your own damn kitchen. Today, y'all know what I'm about to tell you. Today, oh Lord, we're gonna make a leftover dish. I'm gonna show you how to take some vegetables that you may not have eaten all the way up, and we're gonna make a casserole. Yes, we are, in your own damn kitchen. Y'all ready? Let's get gangster in the kitchen. Okay guys, so listen. Yesterday I grilled and roasted and then brought the eggplant into my kitchen and put it in the oven with some Parmesan cheese. Well, I didn't eat it all. So I thought, oh, this would be great to make a lasagna, if you will, a vegetable casserole. So I'm gonna use these roasted eggplant. Right now I have some zucchini, so I'm going to show you how I cut these zucchini, okay? And then I'm going to show you what I want. I left one so I can show you what to do if you want to be gangster like me. I took a cauliflower head, and what I did was I blanched it, right? I got it a little too soft, but that's all right because it's going to get nice and crispy. Y'all see that? Okay, so listen, this is so good, y'all. Lord have mercy. Why is it so good, Cabrini? Well, y'all see the spot right here? Hold on. Y'all see the spot right here? I boiled some water. Then I added my better than bouillon. Y'all better get that as vegetarian. And this one is roasted garlic, okay? So I put that in there and I put my cauliflower in there. And so now what do I have? Roasted garlic, vegetable broth that I can use, that I made myself. And you can too, in your own damn kitchen. Okay, so then I put it in the refrigerator so it can cool off. That's why I'm able to touch it. Now, the zucchini. So I said, okay, I'm gonna make it in my little casserole dish, right? It's gonna be a little small one. Y'all see that? Okay, I'm gonna show y'all how to do it. Don't fear, Gangster Chef is here. Okay, so I took this zucchini, because sometimes, you know, when you cut the zucchini, it could be long enough, but then when you want to get to the other end, let me show you, it'll come this way, and then you'll have this area. Anyway, so we're gonna create something. Okay, so I cut it in half, right? Then, can y'all see this? Oh, shit. Okay, so then, let me go this way. I cut it like that, right? Now, this end, I don't like that. So now I'm gonna cut it again. I'm gonna cut it again, right? I'm gonna cut it again. Y'all hold your fingers in, people. And I'm gonna cut it again, and then I have that end again, right? So remember, I have my broth water over here. And guess what I'm doing with these end butts? They're going in the water. The water's nice and hot. So now I'm adding zucchini to my broth water. Ooh, Lord have mercy. Okay, y'all see that? Boom. Time and time again. Okay, now, once I finish with this, we're going to assemble, which is the funnest, is that a word? The most fun part is assembling, putting together your lasagna, casserole. Okay, boom. All right, so the vegetables that I have zucchini, mushrooms, eggplant, cauliflower, and I made some ground turkey with ground pork. Oh, y'all see that stem right there? Guess where it's going? In the broth. And that's gonna sit and marinate and do all that. So,
there's a Supercuts right around the corner. I walked in.
This one's not going in there. But when you have vegetables or leftovers in your kitchen, in your refrigerator, be creative, people. Think of, what can I make with this? Ooh, what would Gangster Chef make? That's what we're gonna do. Okay, so now let's put it together. Oh, y'all get some cheese, people. Get the cheese you like. I'm using mozzarella and a pizza blend. Okay, all right. Okay, guys. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna season everybody, right? Now, if I had not blanched, because I was running my mouth this too much, when I would cut this as my little steak, y'all see that? It would be a little firmer, but that's okay. Because otherwise I could just do crumbles just crumble it inside the casserole part. Let me show you how I got to make this steak. All right, so we have our head, right? All right, so you take your head and you, wait a minute. I don't have a camera, people, yet. It's coming, y'all. Okay, you see the head? Can y'all see? Wait a minute. Go down a little bit. All right, so you wanna just cut it long ways. Keep that core in there. Do not take the core out because we need the core to keep it together. Y'all know how the core keeps everything together. That's why they tell you to strengthen your core. Okay, so here's the core. Okay, so when I make the vegetable casserole, it's gonna lay in there flat. Oh, it's gonna be just beautiful. All right, y'all. Y'all see that? Beautiful. All right, y'all. This part might be a little time consuming, but this is why I teach you how to fall in love with yourself and get some nice music on and get, you know, have a beverage or some juice or something that you like to drink. And you wanna just use a damp paper towel and just brush the dirt off your mushrooms. Do not, did I repeat? Did y'all hear me say do not? Do not wash your mushrooms in water. Because mushrooms are already water packed. So if you add water to them, then it's just gonna get mushy. And then, you know, all of a sudden you got some mushiness going on. So you don't wanna do that, okay? So just brush them off, talk to them. Thank them for, you know, coming out so beautiful. And being so helpful to my sister. Thank you, mushroom. Thank you, mushroom. I'm gonna eat you up. Okay. So, do that. This is a pack that I'm using of baby Bella mushrooms. Okay, and then, so there you go. Don't make your paper towel so wet, just damp. You just wanna brush that dirt off, okay? All right, y'all. Okay, y'all, so listen. Ooh, look all that loveliness. Wait. What I would do if I was not using this for a casserole dish, I would have popped this stem out and I would have put it in my broth water. But because I need that core, I'm going to slice it. Can y'all see? I'm going to slice it and I want that core in there because, again, I want it to lay down like that, okay? So y'all go on and cut your mushrooms, and I'll be back. Okay, guys, so I'm using avocado oil. It's sesame avocado oil. So I added some sesame oil to it as well. And so now I'm gonna toss that around and season it with some Gangsta Chef seasoning. All right, y'all, that's the Gangsta Chef seasoning coming to a container near you. Okay. Toss that about and get everybody nice and coated. Too is if you don't use all of your vegetable, it's seasoned for another dish. Okay, so make sure everybody's coated and let's start assembling. Okay, y'all. I found something fabulous. I found some broccoli. Y'all see this? I found some broccoli. So I was wondering what was my green component going to be besides the zucchini. Okay, so I blanched it just so I could get it nice and tender, pop out that green up in there. And y'all know where I blanched it, right? In my broth. Now I have real vegetable broth with broccoli in it. Ooh, Lord. Okay. All right, y'all. So now, let's assemble. Another thing I want to talk to you guys about. Now, I didn't pay attention to this when I bought my pots. You want to make sure when you buy pots that the handles do not get hot. I got these from Costco. And, well, sometimes Costco has great things, but no. No, no, no. All right, so here we go. Okay. Again, when you are cutting your zucchini, you want to make sure it's really thin, okay, so it can lay flat. Okay, because otherwise, what's going to happen, you see, this is a very small, oh, do y'all see? Can y'all see? Okay. This is a very small casserole dish, so I'm not going to have a lot of space to put a lot of nothing. So I have to really be creative. See, some of them are too fat. I can't put them in. Okay, because I'm only doing one layer of zucchini, one layer of eggplant. You see that? Mm-hmm. You could go on the outskirts over here, because remember we want to take over all the real estate up in here. Okay.
Whole Foods Market is here to help you remember how to summer. And we've got the exceptional ingredients you need to make the most of it.
Now, 25% off cut, I'm going to add some meat. Those of you that are vegetarian, just use only the vegetables.
Learn more on the Whole Foods Market app.
I'm only doing one layer of meat.
Take the guardrails off.
Because I ain't got no room.
Summer on at Whole Foods Market. Sorry to interrupt your playlist, but we had to tell you about Ashley's extended Memorial Day sale. You still have time to shop incredible Memorial Day doorbusters. And through Monday,
okay, wait. For every I need some more meat up in here.
Spent, receive a $100
I need some more meat. Okay, y'all. And when you're putting it in there, press it down so that we can get a little more space. Do y'all see that? Okay, now I'm going to add a layer of cheese. I mixed mozzarella and the Mexican cheese together. Next layer is gonna be the mushrooms, okay? So let's go, we could just stack the mushrooms, fill up the pan with mushrooms, okay? Okay, y'all, so now you see my cauliflower. The reason why I wanted you to make it like a steak, because now it can lay right on top. Y'all see that? Do y'all see that? Okay. So now, I'm gonna lay my cauliflower on top. And if I have the crumbles, I'll fit the crumbles in between. And then I'm gonna do the same thing with the broccoli. I'm gonna only do crumbles with the broccoli. I'm not gonna okay, y'all, I'm sorry, I'm concentrating, I'll be right there. Okay, y'all, so now I'm gonna top it with some cheese. I'll put the broccoli through there. I'm gonna top it with cheese. You guys, preheat your oven to 450 degrees. And what you want is all of this to melt in here. You do not put a foil on here. And if you do, leave it lifted so that the cheese does not get stuck on the foil, okay? Now, I'm gonna press this down and I'm gonna see, let's see if we could put a lid on it. Y'all know what about a lid? Look at that lid. Oh, ho, 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 ho. I think we could put a lid on it. That's just beautiful. That's just absolutely beautiful. Look at that. There's the lid, y'all. Now, of course, it's gonna get nice and roasty and toasty on top of there. let's go that way so we can get it all up in there. Because the end was a little problematic. Let me see, wait a minute. Can you go this way? Yeah, you can. Okay. Can y'all see? Okay, yeah, you can. Yeah, you can. Are you paying attention, people? This is fabulous. Fabulous. Now, here's what it occurred to me as well. Hold on, I'm gonna show it to you. It occurred to me, y'all see that? Jeez, wait, hold on. I need to see y'all. All right, wait, hold on. All right, y'all, so I can hold it now because it ain't been cooked yet. Jeez. Okay, it occurred to me, you see that right up in there? It looks dry, right? So I'm gonna have to add a little bit of my broth here and some vegetable, some of the seasoned broth. Oh, let me show y'all. Some of the seasoned broth that's in here. Pour that through there. And it's seasoned, so that's gonna make it even better, more better. Okay, now, I have all this fabulous vegetables left. I can eat it as a snack. All right, y'all, let's go to the oven. Let's start with 20 minutes, okay? And then we'll take a look. Everybody's oven is different, so let's do 20 minutes on 450. Preheat your oven, people. Okay, y'all, so while the lasagna slash casserole, vegetable casserole, is baking, I wanted to talk about, so I can no longer allow COVID to be the excuse for me to gain weight, honey. You know, everybody got that COVID weight. Oh, girl, that's my COVID weight. No, thank you. And I know for me, carbs tend to keep me bloated. And I have gained, 10, 12 pounds, and I don't want them. So I'm going to give them back to you. So I'm going back to low carb and then transitioning into keto. Now, keto and maybe low carb is not for everyone. So you can modify this by adding breadcrumbs or adding things that you like that are carb friendly and are carb heavy. Like the dish I made right here, you could add lasagna noodle. And that can also be your way of not having it just be vegetables, okay? So I just wanted to make sure you knew that when I do keto dishes and or low carb, it is not to enhance you. It is only what I enjoy, and it's not for everyone. So, pick and choose your carbs and your vegetables accordingly. And let's get ready to taste this amazing vegetable casserole meat something that's from the refrigerator leftovers. But think of something to call it. But I just wanted to let y'all know that. Okay, so I'll be right back. But there's something about your love that makes me weak and knocks me off my feet. There's something about your love that makes me weak and knocks me off my feet. That knocks me off my feet. Y'all, I could just hear my mother singing this right now. You within. Oh, but I love you, I love you, I love you. I don't wanna bore you within. Oh, but I love you, I love you, I love you more and more. We cook inside our kitchens, waiting for our dishes to be prepared, and then we'll eat them with our friends, and then they all fall in love with the dish you cooked and want you to cook for them. But then you say, I don't want to bore you with my food. But there's something about my food that makes you happy and knocks you off your feet. There's something about my food that makes you weak and knocks you off your feet. That knocks you off your feet. I'm not gonna cook for you, 'cause I want you to do it yourself, yourself. I'm not gonna cook for you, 'cause I want you to cook in your own damn kitchen. I'm not gonna cook for you, 'cause I want you to cook your own food in your kitchen. What? You with it. Oh, but I love you, I love you, I love you. I'm not gonna cook for you, 'cause you gonna kick it cooking your own damn kitchen. Okay, y'all, so this is after 20 minutes. Now, I was able to push it down, but now I'm gonna add some cheese on top, okay? And we're gonna put it back in the oven for another 10 minutes, okay? And I'm gonna show you, we wanna get it crispy on top. So I'm gonna put it on broil, but when I do that, when you do that at your home, you gotta make sure you watch it, okay? Because we're gonna get it nice and crispy and bubbly, and then we're gonna turn it off, okay? All right, y'all, so one of the reasons why I told you do not wash your mushrooms is because if you don't use them all, and when you wanna put them in the refrigerator, they're dry, and they're already clean. So you put a lid on them, and go on about your damn business, and use it for something else, like a nice egg cheese omelet. That's all. Carry on. Okay, guys, you see that right now? It's melted, right? So now we're gonna flash it. Take it to broil, put it on high for 5 minutes, okay? All right, y'all. Y'all see that crunchiness? All right, so now we're gonna let it rest. Yes, indeed. It get in the way of what I'm feeling. Sister girl. Hey, y'all. Hey, I'm back. And guess what? It has set, honey. The casserole has set. It's still a little warm. I've been to the gym and I'm back. And yes, I still look the same. I was in my work clothes. So don't even, whatever. Workout clothes. Okay, so here's the thing. And I've washed my hands and I have on a new shirt. I've taken a shower before y'all start talking shit. Okay, so here she is. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to, I only want a small piece, right? So, I'm gonna, wait, let me get a right knife. I'll be right back. Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna go this way. Y'all see how I can do that? That means that it has set very well, okay? I'm gonna go like this because I want a small piece. So I'm gonna do a small cut with that one. Can y'all see? Oh, shit. Sorry, y'all. Y'all see that? Cheese. Okay, I'll be right. Hold on. Now. I love this spoon, this spatula thingy. I mean, it's a spatula. There's, you know, the holes there, and then there's a little spoony thing here. So now I'm gonna get some of the juice. That would be so nice. All right. All right, now I'm gonna eat it in front of y'all. Cheese, please. Ooh. That would be so nice. Cheese. Wait, let me get my focus here. Cheese. Y'all know I gotta say cheese. Okay. Now let me eat it. Oh, wait, hold on. Okay, y'all. Hold on, let me twirl it down. Can y'all see? That would be so nice. Oh my Lord. Oh my Lordy. Oh my Lordy. Ooh, if you eat right. Oh, shit. If you think right, people. When you drink right. When you do that, look at that. Watch that. Y'all, let me tell you something. When you do all that, you can't help but feel right. I'm gonna tell you something. You can't help but fall in love with yourself in your own damn kitchen. When you know you made this, you did this. You did this. And you don't have to wait on DoorDash or Grubhub or all them people. You've cooked it in your own kitchen. Those of you that need to use those services, I ain't bashing. I'm just saying. Anyway, I love y'all. I love what I do. I love doing this with you. And every time I create a dish for you, I think of how you might feel so empowered, inspired, and excited about your damn self in your own damn kitchen. I'm Gangsta Chef Cabrini. Please subscribe to the channel, honey. Hit the little belly thing and like it. And then share it to some other folk that might need it. But I'm thanking you from the bottom of my entire body. And I want y'all to go in the bathroom or wherever you got a mirror. I want you to kiss yourself in the mirror like this. And know that's a kiss from me to you. I see y'all in the next video.